KPRC. Hi, everybody. We are live here on the KPRC2 YouTube page. Randy McAvoy, Ari Alexander. You know, I mean, based on where we're behind us, you know we're at the ballpark. Minute Maid Park, the home opener for the Astros. Good feeling. We got some fans here, Ari. You're getting the sounds of baseball back here.
This was so, so strange last year when we would come to the ballpark, and this place is completely empty. Yep. There's a couple people walking around cleaning and picking up trash, and then there's a baseball game going on. So this is at least, you know what it reminds me of? With the limited amount of fans, because we don't see too many since it's super early, it's like a Florida Marlins game. You know, Florida Marlins game. And so this is nice just to see the jerseys. We got, you know, like the Tequila Sunrise jerseys are back. We got fans hanging out, eating popcorn, drinking beer, watching BP.
I love walking the concourse because the concession stands were open, and the last year you didn't smell anything. And now you smell everything. They've got the concession stands open, but we are here. This is a 50% capacity of Minute Maid Park, so they're going to have, 21,000 fans here. And everybody's spread out. That's the good news. And it's health and safety measures are in place all over the ballpark, hand sanitizing stations, and I mean, you name it, they've got it taken care of here to prepare for this game.
Yeah, I think fans are going to come here to a ballpark and feel safe. I know I was excited for baseball, and I think what they've done, everything is touchless. You have your little ticket, you know, on a QR code on your phone. You come in, there is hand sanitizer absolutely everywhere. Doors are open. There's not a lot of stuff you have to, like, walk through. And so I think for fans that are maybe a little bit hesitant at once spending the money on a ticket for a family to go to a baseball game, I do think it's going to be a good experience, especially because you haven't done this for almost, you know, a year and a half now.
Yeah, it's been, I think the World Series ended in 2019, Game 7. I think it was like November 1st or something like that. So this is the first time since that Game 7 that fans are back in this building, and you can kind of sense the excitement, the buzz is building, although there will only be 20 or 21,000. It's probably going to sound like there's 40,000 in here. They're going to be so excited and really vocal tonight to cheer on the Astros again.
I mean, plus, you have an Astros team that has come out hot this season. They're playing a Oakland A's team that has struggled. So I think fans are going to expect to see wins. They're going to want to see wins here early in the season. And this Astros lineup, despite not having George Springer, who is now in the Blue Jays, despite not having a couple of the guys that they've had in these championship runs or these pennant runs, this team can still hit and put up runs and win, you know, free Chick-fil-A or free tacos or whatever it is for fans. And I think when Christian Javier gets on that mound tonight, you are going to hear a reaction.
No doubt. He's going to make his second start tonight. I think McCullers goes tomorrow night. It's a weird series. This is only a three-game series. It's a Thursday, Friday, Saturday series. And you're saying, okay, why are they not playing Sunday? I don't know. It's just kind of what they're doing. You're going to see a little bit of that on schedules for all the teams this year, a little bit different. So a rare Sunday off for the Astros, and then they're back at it Monday when the Tigers come here. Their manager, A.J. Hinch, makes his return. So everything kind of getting back to a sense of normalcy, if you will. But the team, Ari's going to monitor this whole COVID situation, the capacity. Ideally, they would love to gradually increase this a little bit as the season goes along, but they're very conservative in the approach they're doing. I think it's smart right now to start low.
It's definitely different than the approach the Texas Rangers have taken, where they're like full go, 100% fans. But then if you look at some other ballparks, Texas is obviously given a little bit more leeway than other states. So I'm going to New York to go to a Mets game to see the Mets next week. They're 20% capacity. You have to prove that you've either been fully vaccinated or take a negative test within 72 hours. So I asked Anita Seagal about that yesterday. Did you guys consider that? Is that something you went through? And they said, we talked to the health department, we talked to the officials in the city, we talked to the officials in the state, and that's just something that's not required. So what you're gonna see in terms of requirements to go to ballparks, not just capacity, just like the things that you need to do to go to a baseball game, it's not going to be uniform around Major League Baseball. It's going to be on a state-by-state basis. And so when the Astros go to California, for instance, there's going to be a different percent crowd. If you're a fan that wants to, you know, travel to see the Astros in a road game, you might have to do different things than if you're coming to Minute Maid Park.
So some of the things we've noticed, too, besides the hand sanitizer stations, if you see it, I don't know if you can see it with Howard's phone or not, but right above the dugout are plexiglass windows. You'll see that. That's new. Over both dugouts. So again, just to keep the separation. It's all about keeping these players separated from the fans best possible to allow them to be here but still play this baseball game. So just little things have stood out to me since arriving here in the ballpark. So we've noticed that, but the fans will be here. They're filing in now. They'll be spread out. There's no concern over a super spreader event because the Astros have really planned this out well, and I think they're in pretty good shape there.
Yeah, for now, I mean, we're going to see the things like that, like to separate the players, because they're still technically in sort of a bubble. Not to the point of where the NBA bubble was last year, but it's sort of a bubble until 85% of the team is vaccinated. And so once they get to that point, the rules are relaxed across Major League Baseball. That's where I think there was a story came out last week about the Cardinals where they were like getting there. And so Major League Baseball is asking these teams, you hit 85% of your 26-man roster vaccinated, the rules relax a little bit in terms of what the bubble situation is.
All right, so here we go. It's a home opener. It's going to be a fun season, I think. The Astros are projected to win 90-95 games, if you want to go with that.
The division.
And win the division. It's all about staying healthy, and I think we follow this team. It's all about it. Well, they're going to score runs. They got to stay healthy. We know that. They need Yordan Alvarez to stay in this lineup as much as possible. They got to have the pitching, man. It's got it like any team, but especially this team with no Verlander. You've got Javier needs to deliver. Urquidy needs to deliver. They'll get Framber Valdez back eventually. They feel like they've got the arms that can get it done and shut people down.
I think one thing that's going to be difficult early in the season is seeing the pitchers go deep in games, because we saw in these first 5-6 games, the bullpen got taxed pretty quickly, and that's something that you just don't, especially when you're in a week where you're going into a second series, you do not want your bullpen taxed for that second series. And so that puts pressure on guys like Lance McCullers, who has had a history of injuries, doesn't always go deep in games. Christian Javier, who's kind of a swing man where he can be in the bullpen if they get Jake Odorizzi back and they get Framber Valdez back. So he's not really a guy who's going to give you 7 or 8. And so that puts more pressure on Greinke, meaning like you need to give them 7 every time you're a start. And so that's one thing I think we're going to notice early in the year is how taxed is this bullpen going to get? How many guys is Dusty Baker going to want that are long relievers just in case Luis Garcia goes 3 1/3 and you need to have like Brandon Belak come in and clean up 4 innings?
Well, I think the beauty of it is you've got the new AAA team in Sugar Land is about 30 minutes down the road, down 59. So they need to rotate some arms to get them up here even temporarily. They can call on Sugarland. So I think we're actually going to see a lot of movement in the months ahead as the season kind of develops and gets going. So
yeah, alternate sites is going to be a good thing for all these teams.
All right, I think we're going to wrap it up here on YouTube Live for KPRC2. Ari Alexander, Randy McAvoy here at Minute Maid Park, the home opener for the 2021 season. Hope you enjoy the coverage here, all over the air and online. Click to Houston.com as well. Take care.
All right, play ball, Houston.